Today we're going to discuss the three components that make up the structure of a nucleotide, the different types of nucleotides, and what they do within the body. We all know that DNA, or deoxyribonucleic acid, acts as our genetic material. You might also know that it holds the genetic code, written in the four nucleotide bases: adenine, A, guanine, G, thymine, T, and cytosine, C. These bases are found within structures called nucleotides. But what are nucleotides made of? Let's find out more about nucleotides and their structure. DNA, the molecule containing the information to build and maintain the normal functioning of an organism, is made from long chains of organic molecules called nucleotides. There are four different types of nucleotides in DNA, and the only difference between them is their nitrogenous base, whether it's A, T, G, or C. The three main components of a nucleotide are as follows. 1. A nitrogenous base. It's either a purine with a bicyclic structure or a pyrimidine with just one ring. 2. A phosphate group. This can be a monophosphate, diphosphate, or triphosphate, depending on how many phosphates make up the group. And 3. A 5-carbon sugar. This sugar can either be a ribose sugar with an OH group at position 2, or a deoxyribose sugar with a hydrogen atom at position 2. The full name of DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, gives you a clue about which type of sugar it contains, deoxyribose. In RNA, on the other hand, the sugar is ribose. How are these three components connected? Well, the base is covalently bonded to the 1' carbon of the sugar. The sugars and phosphate groups of nucleotides are linked by phosphodiester bonds, forming what's called a sugar-phosphate backbone. The 5' carbon of one sugar is bonded to the phosphate group within the same nucleotide, and this phosphate group is then linked to the 3' carbon of the sugar in the adjacent nucleotide. In this way, the nucleotides are connected in a chain. DNA is a polymer made of two chains of nucleotides. Complementary bases are connected via hydrogen bonding between the chains. Let's take a closer look at the four bases in DNA. Adenine and guanine are both purines, which are present in DNA and RNA. Cytosine and thymine are both pyrimidines. While cytosine is present in both DNA and RNA, RNA contains uracil instead of thymine. In DNA, adenine bonds with thymine and guanine bonds with cytosine. 22% of human DNA nucleotides contain adenine, and so an equivalent 22% contain its complementary base, thymine. 28% contains cytosine, so another 28% contains its complementary base, guanine. So far, we've discussed nucleotides in the context of DNA and storing genetic information, but in fact, the role of nucleotides in the body goes beyond this. NAD, NADP, and NADPH are nucleotides that function as coenzymes and cofactors, speeding up biochemical reactions. They're essential to redox reactions. ATP is the primary energy molecule of the cell. It stores energy in its bonds, which it can release by expelling a phosphate group to fuel other cellular processes. Finally, cyclic adenosine monophosphate, or cAMP, is a nucleotide essential for transporting chemical signals and regulating metabolism. It's vital for carbohydrate and lipid metabolism. Don't get nucleotides confused with nucleosides. While nucleotides contain three components, sugar, phosphate, and base, a nucleoside contains only two, a sugar and a base. A nucleotide is a nucleoside with a phosphate group. Nucleosides typically end in "-sine." For example, adenosine is the name of the nucleoside containing adenine. DNA consists of adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine as the four main nucleotide bases, whereas RNA consists of adenine, guanine, cytosine, and uracil. In summary, we learned the basic structure of a nucleotide and its three components. We also covered the various types of nucleotides and their specific roles in the body. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching.